Chris Amott and Mike Newman, Karen and Dusty Bin, and the 3-2-1 girl.
Thank you. Thank you very much indeed. Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome once again to 3-2-1, the show that's finger-flicking good. Now, can anybody remember how to do this? Does anybody know how to do that? You haven't forgotten, have you? Try, get your fingers up. Go on. If you make a mistake, I promise I won't hold it against you. Go on. But ladies and gentlemen, it's nice to be back with another series, and people are always asking me what it's all about. Well, if you don't know what 3-2-1 is all about now, I'll tell you. The show comprises of prizes and surprises of all shapes and sizes, clues and disguises, subtle devices which someone devises to put you in a crisis. But as often arises, the fella advises, the girl sympathises, their choice harmonises, the couple realises what the clue symbolises, and that summarises how you win prizes on 3-2-1. It's as simple as that. How are you, Karen? Karen Palmer, ladies and gentlemen. Lovely to see you again, Karen. And, of course, you know who. Our resident booby prize, Dusty Bin. Everyone tries to avoid him, because if they win him, they take home a brand new dustbin. So, Karen, take him away. We'll see the pair of you a bit later on in the show.
See you later.
Well, off you go. See you, Dusty. Bye. Now, we do have one or two changes that I'll explain as we go along, ladies and gentlemen, because we are going to make the show a bit more exciting for you. Well, you've met the gang. Come along and meet the most important people on our program, as ever, our contestants, who are going to play. 3-2-1.
My couple, Julie and David Foggin from here in Leeds.
My couple are Janice and Jim Irvin from Denny in Stirlingshire.
My couple are Vicky and Jeff Davidson from Uckfield in East Sussex.
Thank you, Jenny. Okay, fine. Well, ladies and gentlemen, this is our 1,000-to-1 quiz where our couples can win up to £1,000. But here's the first change. We're not going to have three rounds of questions, we'll just have two. But the couples will be playing for £10 for each correct answer, which means if they score 10, end of the first round, they'll have £100. But whatever they have got at the end of the first round, that is the amount they're playing for in the second round. If they get 10 again, that would be £1,000. Now, the change number two is that at the end of the quiz, the couple with the lowest amount leave us at that point. They do not come back next week. The remaining two couples then play a game, which eliminates one out. One goes through to part three, where all the big prizes can be won. So you've got to get 10 correct questions in 30 seconds. That's what we're looking for. That way you might be on the way to £1,000. But we do have here Jeff and Vicky Davidson from Sussex. Whereabouts in Sussex?
Uckfield, East Sussex.
Uckfield, oh, yeah, I know. And it says here, Jeff, you work for a photocopying company, but you used to run a pub.
That's right, yes.
And where was the pub?
In London, South London.
Oh, from London. You come from London originally?
Yes, yeah,
I see. Sort of the same job, really, isn't it? Photocopying and pub.
Oh, very similar.
Yeah. See, you see, but double in both cases. Anyway, and you, this is interesting. Vicky, you, at one time, you were 11 years old and you were a St Trinian's girl. Tell us about that.
Well, I went to stage school and did a couple of, you know, crowd scenes in St Trinian's films, which was quite good fun.
Did you enjoy?
Yes, I did very much.
Fond memories? Really?
Well, there was one half, unhappy memory or happy memory. I got a bucket of whitewash paint thrown over me.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, dear.
You still got some on you, Ed.
Not as bad as you painted, I'm sure. Listen, let's have the questions from Mireille. How are you, Mireille?
Tout va très bien, Madame la Marquise, Madame McMahon, tout va très bien. On est allé en vacances, on s'est dynamisé, c'était formidable. Tout le monde était avec nous, on est allé se promener, on avait nos chiens.
She says she's got a sore throat and she can't talk. Thank you, Marie. Off you go. Right, okay. In the first round, as you play for £10 for each correct answer, we were not going to give you one to start with in this round. We like them to answer alternately, okay? That's Vicky, of course, first. And there are three ways which we can stop them. If they make a mistake, repeat an answer, or indeed, if the time runs out, that's when we're going to hear from one of our resident comedians. This week, it happens to be Mr. Mike Newman.
I just nearly need to have something here, something warm for the winter, you know. I've had a terrible cold. I went into a chemist yesterday. I said, can you make me something up? He said, Prince Charles was in here yesterday. I said, was he? He said, no, I just made it up.
Right. Our couples have chosen one of three envelopes at random, so either of them could have any set of questions, and these are yours, Vicky and Jeff, for £10 for each correct answer. Good luck to you. We want traditional activities that can take part in a fairground, OK? Traditional activities that you can take part in on a fairground. We'll give you an example, but you must not use it. Big wheel, all right? So traditional activities that you can take part in a fairground, go.
Coconut shy.
Darts.
Goldfish.
Hooking the ducks.
Octopus ride.
Bumper cars.
Goodness. Dodgems. Thank you.
Fairgrounds, fairgrounds. There's two drunks in Blackpool and they're flashing around on the Big Dipper. One fella says to the other, he said, hey, Charlie, I think we're on the wrong bus.
Like that. But Jeff and Vicky, you did repeat there. You said dodgems and bumper cars. You said bumper cars, didn't you, Vicky?
No, you said bumper cars.
Oh, that was Jeff. Okay. But in fact, what did they score, Mary? What did they do?
Vicky and Jeff got 6 points, so they win £60.
£60. Okay. Janice and Jim Irving from Denny and Stirlingshire, is that right?
That's right.
Yes, you've not got one of a strong Scots accent, though, Jim, have you?
That depends.
Whether you're up there or down here.
That's right. Yeah.
Nice to have you here. What does it say here? It says that you've got an interesting job, is that right? Yes. Well, tell us about it. What do you do?
I sell greeting cards.
Really?
Yep.
You mean all greeting cards?
All types, yeah. All times of the year.
Is there one special one that you like that's a good sort of joke card?
A few filthy ones, but it's a family show.
There's big business in that, isn't there, really? I'd love to get one, you know, that said, congratulations on getting the mortgage. That would be pretty good. Oh, dear, I must say, it's nice to have you. And what about you, Janice? Do you work? Do you go out at all?
I do, I work, yes.
Yes, what do you do?
I work for a Scottish bus group.
Bus group?
Uh-huh. Statistics department.
Oh, you said that group too? Statistics department. That's pretty good. It's nice to have you. Incidentally, you're up there. Who do you support football at all? Who's
yes, Glasgow Rangers.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Better keep quiet for about that. Yeah. Leeds United is very strong down here, you know that. Okay, Marie, can we have their questions, please? Nice to have you here. And as you know, same procedure. Answer alternately. You're going for £10 each correct answer. You have to beat 60 at the moment. So, we want characters that appear in traditional stories from Robin Hood, all right? We'll give you an example to start with, but you must not use it, Robin Hood. So, characters that appear in the traditional stories of Robin Hood, go.
Friar Tuck.
Maid Marian.
Little John.
Sheriff of Nottingham.
I've got it. Look at this.
There's a fella up in jail for shooting his wife. No, I'm sorry. There's a fella in court. That's a fella. There's a fella in court for shooting his wife with a bow and arrow. The judge says, why did you shoot your wife with a bow and arrow? He said he didn't want to wake the kids.
Good. Well, Janice and Jim, you ran out of time there, but how did they do then, Marie?
Janice and Jim got 4 points, so they win £40.
£40. £40. Okay. And our third couple, Julie and David from Leeds. That's right.
That's right.
Mr. and Mrs. Oh, we've got a few ripple in the audience. Mr. Foggin. Sounds like a weather forecast, doesn't it? I bet you get a few gags on that, don't you?
Oh, you bet.
Yeah. I'm sure you do, Will. And this is rather interesting, actually. How did you two meet? Come on, tell us.
Well, we met in the ice rink, actually, Ted, and yes. I was showing off. There was a lovely girl skating around. I thought, I'll try and jump this rope barrier and impress her. And yeah. I did.
What happened?
I knocked myself out. I tripped over the rope barrier, and then Julie knows the rest of the story because I don't remember much about it. Well,
what's the rest of the story, Julie?
Well, it was at Bradford, and he had to go to Bradford Royal Infirmary, and so I went with him in the ambulance. And he proposed in the ambulance, but he was delirious.
Proposed in the ambulance?
Yeah, I don't regret it.
Must not, I'm sure you don't. Good That's good, isn't it? From it's a knockout, winner take all, and the rest is blankety blank. Okay, well. Thank you. Thank you for their questions, and you know the scene now. £10 each correct answer. Alternately, good luck to the two of you. Now then, we want names of animals, not birds, which have traditionally been hunted for ages in this country. Through the ages, sorry. We want the names of animals, not birds, which have been traditionally hunted through the ages in this country. We will accept the various special words for deer, so animals that have been hunted, and we will give you an example, but you must not use it, badger. Okay, ready? Go.
Wild boar.
Fox.
Rabbit.
Fawn.
Wolf.
Doe. Doe the deer, the female deer.
Oh dear.
Wife said to me last week, she said, I'd like a coat made out of animal skin. So I bought her a donkey jacket.
He's mean, he's mean. Well, I'm afraid you ran out of time there, David and Julie. You could have said a lot more, like hare, bear, polecat, wild goat, red deer, otter. Goes on, yeah. Of course. But nevertheless, how'd they do, Mireille?
Julie and David got 6 points, so they win £60.
£60. The situation here at the end of the first round, we've got Janice and Jim here on £40, but level pegging Jeff, Vicky, and David and Julie on £60. That's it. So, Jeff and Vicky on £60. OK, Mireille, can we have their second questions, please? Got to do well this time. Try and get 10. You'd have 600 then, you know that, don't you? Right. Questions are slightly different this time, only in as much as we still want you to answer alternately. I will ask you the questions individually, okay? But, of course, if you don't know the answer, tell me you don't know and I'll go on to the next question, all right? And, of course, there are only two ways that they can be stopped this time, if they make a mistake or if the time runs out. So, £60 for each correct answer. Good luck to you. We want countries bordering on other countries. We will give you a country and we want you to give us any one neighbouring country, all right? And, of course, I'm going to give you one to start with this time. That is the difference in this round to the last round. I'll give you one to start with this time. Portugal touches Spain, so Portugal touches Spain. Next one, USA.
Canada.
Sweden.
Denmark.
Funny, I went on holiday last year to the Canary Islands. Funny place, the Canary Islands, you know. All the ground is covered in sandpaper.
I wonder why. Well, I'm afraid you did make a mistake there, Vicky. You said Sweden was bordering. You know where it's not. It borders Norway and Finland, OK? So, Mireille, how did they do at the end of the second round?
Vicky and Jeff got 2 points, so they win £120.
£120. Yeah. OK. Right, Janice and Jim on £40. Could we have their second questions, please? Thank you very much, Mireille. Well, now. OK, a maximum of 10 will give you 400. OK, here we go. We want rivers on which famous cities stand. We will give you the city and we want you to give the river. We'll start you with Vienna, standing on the Danube. Vienna, standing on the...
Danube.
Glasgow.
Clyde.
Cairo.
A Nile.
London.
Thames.
Paris.
Seine.
Cologne.
Rhine.
Gloucester. Gloucester.
Seven.
Rome.
Poor.
Rivers, what about a quick impression of the talking river at Stratford? Hello, Avon calling.
Yeah, like that. Well, I'm afraid, Jim, you made a mistake. You did say Rome was on the river Po. P-O? In fact, it's on the River Tiber. I'm sure you know that now. So, Mireille, how did they do at the end of the second round?
Janice and Jim got 7 points, so they win £280.
£280. Very good. Lovely. All right. Julie, David here on 60. Now, that's what you've got to beat. You've got to beat that. Can you do it? 10 right, we'll give you £600. OK, Mireille, can we have their questions? Thank you. Good luck to the two of you. We'll find out right now. We want countries which contain famous mountain ranges. We will give you the range and we want you to give us just one of the countries the range is in, all right? Mm-hmm. We'll start you with the Cairngorms in Scotland. So the Cairngorms in Scotland.
Scotland.
Rocky Mountains.
America.
Snowy Mountains.
Don't know.
Central Massif.
Don't know.
Sierra Madre.
Don't know.
Wicklow Mountains.
clueless.
Sierra Nevadas.
Don't know.
Apennines.
Italy.
Jura Mountains.
I've got a brother, he went on the Irish Everest expedition that failed at 6,000 feet because they ran out of scaffolding.
Oh, I like that. Oh, yes. Like that. Well, David and Julie, you did in fact run out of time. Spain was just after the bell, unfortunately. Uh-huh. You said America. We assume you meant the United States of America.
Oh, yes.
So there. How'd they do, Murray?
Julie and David got 3 points, so they win £180.
So, the situation here at the end of our quiz, what do we have? We've got Vicky and Jeff there on £120. We've got Julie and David on £180, but the winner of the quiz tonight, Jim and Janice, on £280. Well done. Unfortunately, that does mean that the couple with the lowest amount, that's Vicky and Jeff here with £120. Still, it's not a bad night's work, is it?
No, I've enjoyed it.
It's been lovely having you on the show. There's your £120.
Thanks very much.
There's your ceramic dusty bin. Weren't they a lovely couple, folks? Take care. Thank you. Well, that means that couples number two and three will be coming back in part two to play the elimination game, which means one of them will be going forward, part three, to those big, big prizes. Also, when we do come back after the break, ladies and gentlemen, we're going straight into our first sketch. Now, the theme of our show this week is Merry England, so we'll see you in a couple of minutes on 3, 2, 1. Don't go too far away.
Sherwood Forest?
Sherwood Forest. Now, what division are they in?
Roll up! Roll up! Roll up, ladies and gentlemen, roll up! See the pig-faced man, the ugliest man in the world, one groat only.
Tain't worth it.
With a face like yours, I see what you mean. He's a groat. I'll bring him out to see you.
Yeah, you there.
Gather round, ladies and gentlemen, gather round, gather round. I am going to give you, entirely free of charge, one of Dr. Pushcart's magic talisman. This makes your wife more passionate, more desirable, and 10 times more beautiful.
I wouldn't mind a wife like that. How'd it work?
Take this, my boy, and find out for yourself. A little rub is all it needs. But first, just give me 5 groats to cover the cost of bringing it to market.
Oh, they are.
There you are.
Make my wife 10 times more beautiful.
Hello, my darling.
Ye gods, it works.
I don't believe it.
Hey, I wouldn't mind one of them for my wife. My God, she's ugly. She's got a face like a mortal sin. She's so ugly, we use her as a scarecrow. Not alone do the birds not take the fruit anymore, they bring back what they took last year.
Oh, come, come, sir. You have just seen living proof. Now, there's one for you, if you'll just give me the 10 groats.
Just a minute. You said only 5 groats.
Ah, it's the second time I brought this one.
Oh, I see. Well, there's 10 groats. magic talisman, make my wife 10 times more beautiful. It works!
started with three couples. We're now down to two. Pretty soon there will be one, because this is the elimination game. We're going to play this game. At the end of it, one of you go forward to those big prizes. Now then, what happens is this. There are three whistles in the game. On the first whistle, you start. And when you start, the girls, you put those helmets on your head, turn around and spike those apples on those trees, and dash over here to your partner. Let him take the apple off and put it straight on one of these boars' heads. On the second whistle, change places with your partner. Fellas, you put the helmet on, you spike the apples, take them back to your wives, stick them on the boars' heads. The one with the most apples over here on the boars' heads, of course, will go through to take it or leave it and those big prizes. Everybody all set? Okay. Karen is here with the whistle. Good luck to the two of you, the four of you. Three, two, one, go.
That's it. Come on, yeah. Turn around. Kill. Next. Come on, turn. That's it. You
on. Okay, come on, change places with your partners. Fellas, put those helmets on. Spike away. Hold it there, hold it there. Those apples on the boar's heads, we'll count them up right here now. I bet that was a tough one, wasn't it?
Was it?
Well, let's come back. Cool down a bit. Get back to your partner and we'll see just who did what there. Who's going to go through to those big prizes? How'd you feel, Julie?
Excited.
How about you then, Janice? How'd you feel?
Exhausted. Hey.
All right then. Patsy, how did your couple do?
Well, my couple scored four.
Four. Annie, how about your couple?
David and Julie scored seven.
Seven. Wow. Yeah. Congratulations. Okay. David and Julie, congratulations. You're going through to have a go at those really big prizes. I must say, commiserations to Jim and Janice. It's been marvellous having you on the show. Okay. You have, of course, got the money you won in the quiz, which was what, Karen?
£280.
£280 in a ceramic dusty bin. Well, there you are.
Thank
There's
you.
A lid. Ah, also. This. A newer 3-2-1 photo frame with, oh, that's me inside, but don't worry about that. There's a picture taken of you during the show, and it's already on its way to you. It's through the post. It'll be at your home pretty soon. Thank you for coming, Jim.
Thank
You've
you
been
very
a great
much.
Contestant. And they've been marvellous, folks. Give them a ripple. God bless. Thank you. Right. Okay, David and Julie, come over here to Ted's table, because this is where all the big prizes are. Now then, Julie, if you'd like to stand just here, would you? And David, if you'd like to go there. Now then, I don't know whether you remember the last series or not, but this is exactly what happens here. Here we want you to really put your thinking caps on, because we have five sketches and there are five prizes. There are four terrific prizes, and we also have the booby prize of Dusty Bin. Don't forget, if you win Dusty Bin, you don't get him, it's a dustbin you get, right? Mm-hmm. Now then, at the end of all of our sketches, one of the characters comes over here to the table, they leave a clue object, and they'll read you a rhyme. Now, when you've got three of those on the table, I'm going to ask you to reject one. When you've rejected four in all, the one remaining will determine the prize that you're going to take home with you tonight, okay? Mm-hmm. Now, on the last series, we did have a motor car every single week. Although we're going to have plenty of motor cars, believe me, we're not going to have one every week, because we found out we lost our excitement when we got down to two on the table. One went, and we all knew that that one had to be the motor car. So you don't know when the motor cars are going to be on, but the prizes are just as terrific, believe you me. Okay? So here from that last sketch, of course, we've got the lovely Rita Webb. Hey, how are you, darling? Hey, Rita. It's lovely of you to come along, I must say that. And you know what upsets me a bit, Rita? We always see you on the box and in films. They always make you play an old battle axe, don't they?
Well, I'm not an old battle axe. I'm a young battle axe.
Okay. What are you doing? What have you done recently?
Well, I've just done a nice film for Walt Disney.
Really?
Called The London Affair, with that lovely bloke, Nigel Davenport,
oh, yeah.
Frank Windsor, and that lovely bloke, I really like him, Julian Orchard.
Well, what do you play?
Oh, I play the part of a beautiful virgin.
It's Fantasia again, is it? Oh, well, look, Rita, what are you going to leave for these lovely people as a clue?
Well, here's the ribbon.
A piece of ribbon? And you've got a rhyme for them too?
Yes, that is a ribbon, but it's not for your hair. And though it needs cutting, no one knows where.
That's the rhyme. Oh, thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, Rita Webb. Thank you, Rita. God bless you, lovely.
Oh, isn't that lovely? Alan, I don't want anybody knows listening.
Oh, dear. She's lovely. Yeah. Well, I don't know whether you made anything of that.
No,
but, well, we've got another one coming up right now, our second sketch, and it's about Tom Jones. There was a fella who had quite a reputation with the ladies. In fact, he bought a four-poster bed, nailed walls to it, and put a door in. Go over now. Let's meet. He's sizing up one of his customers. Let's go over and meet him now. Lovely, Anna Dawson.
You
oh, this is the clue, is it?
Yeah.
Oh. Drives me mad, I'll tell you that. Anna, it's lovely to have you here,
thank
it really
you.
Is. You know, I love seeing you on What's On Next, especially when you do that sexy traffic warden, you know.
Thank you very much.
Do you ever get recognised in the street for that?
Yeah, one fellow even asked me if I'd have him towed away.
What, to the car compound?
No, to my flat.
I don't blame him, do you? Anyway, what are you going to leave as the... That's the clue and you're going to read a rhyme. What
this
does the rhyme
it.
Say?
Step on the juice, don't ask for more. If you take half of this, you're one over the four.
Ah, what do you think, David? Julie?
Step on the juice. Sounds like alcohol. You know, one over the eight, half of it, one over the four. You know what I mean?
Well, I don't know what you mean, but you're working it out pretty good, I must say. Well,
on.
Ladies and gentlemen, lovely Anna Dawson. Thanks,
thank
Anna.
You
there you go, that's what I like. They're really thinking about these tonight. That's beautiful. We're coming up now for a third sketch. After that, you're going to have to reject one. You know, in Merry England, of course, there was a popular thing. It was the tournaments where a knight had to go through special training. I mean, he had to run through a forest, swim a raging river, climb castle battlements, jump off of a horse, moving speed, and then deliver a box milk tray to his bird. We're going over to see one of these sort of fellas right at this moment.
champion?
Well, it's nearly autumn. The nights are getting shorter.
Are you a member of the Round Table?
No, I'm in the Masons.
Aren't you rather small to be a Mason?
Well, I'm a Masonette.
The challenger, Lord Elpas.
I've come to throw down the gauntlet to Sir Percy. Oh, sorry.
What? What is your motto?
My motto is this. He who laughs, laughs, laughs. He who laughs, 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 laughs. An apple a day keeps the doctor away. But for real peace, try an onion. Bum, bum.
What is the nature of this quarrel?
He laughed at me because my potato crop failed.
Why is that?
I couldn't remember where I planted them.
Tobacco!
Tobacco, madam! Come on, come on, come on, come over here. Over here, over here, Red Rock. Sit down, 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 down.
Ready? Get ready to meet your next challenger.
Let him appear.
Congratulations, you beat me fair and square. Get up. Come on.
Good heavens, it's the wife. Well, Ted, I've come to read the rhyme, Ted.
Get out of that.
Dad, what are you going to leave it? No, you're not leaving the helmet.
No, I'm not. I'm taking that back. I'm leaving the gauntlet, actually. This is the
gauntlet.
The gauntlet this time. That goes there. Right. And I have a little poem here, Ted, like this. The nights are getting shorter. The leaves begin to fall. You won't have far to travel if you park against the wall. Den, 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 den.
Mike Newman, ladies and gentlemen.
Thanks,
cheers, Mike.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well, David and Julie, you've heard that from Mike. I can read you the bowl of fruit again, which Anna Dorsa brought on. Of course, the piece of ribbon which Rita Webb brought on. Which would you like to hear again?
The ribbon.
Ah, yeah. Conflict already. You can hear one. I can't read the
that's
two.
That's no, I want to hear that one again, please. Well, the fruit. No, if we have the ribbon, that's the one we last heard. The one that was furthest away when we heard it. Yeah, well, I still know it.
Is there a policeman in the house? Well, what's going to happen? I'll read one.
We better have the bowl of fruit.
Yeah. Sure, Julie? All right, then. David, I'll read you the bowl of fruit. Step on the juice, don't ask for more. If you take half of this, you're one over the four. So, now you have to reject one.
I think that's something to do with booze. That one, don't you? It's
Ooh.
Got fruit.
Well, it would be going to be you.
Yeah. Oh, is he a tippler?
Is he?
Oh, no. That's not fair.
So, listen, what
no,
do you...
I think that's something to do with booze.
Okay, Julie, you're going to go along with that?
Yeah.
Yes?
I think this one could be the bin, because it could be an anagram. If you cut it...
Cut ribbon.
Cut ribbon. It's
so, you, well, what do you think? You have to reject one. I'm going to make you reject.
That one.
What?
Yeah, let's reject.
We think that's a bin.
You're rejecting the ribbon?
Let's reject the ribbon.
Yeah.
You sure?
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, totally sure. Right, let's see what it says. Rita Webb brought this in. Here is a ribbon. It's not for your hair. Although it needs cutting, no one knows where. Right. Okay, yes, believe it or not, this was your prize. We'd have asked you to cut the ribbon. That's all we would have done. Got a pair of scissors here. You'd cut the ribbon.
Yeah.
Right. What else would you do? Well, of course, then we would ask you to have it hung on this map of the world. Along a certain line of latitude, you could have had a two-week holiday. What a marvellous prize. Now, come and look. Look at this. Okay, I cut it. If you'd have won it, I'd have asked you to have cut it. You could have gone anywhere there. America, right across there. But then, of course, you could have had 2 weeks in Siberia. I don't suppose you'd like that, would you? Stay there a moment. Well, first one gone. First rejection. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back in just a couple of minutes with more prizes and more clues on 3, 2, 1. Don't go too far away. Thank
Thank you. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to part three of 3-2-1, where David and Julie have just rejected a holiday for 2 weeks anywhere at a certain point around the world, and I believe they wanted to go to America. Anyway, we're going to have another sketch right now. You know, in merry England, there was no merrier place than the Village Inn, where busty buxom barmaids in tight blouses would lean over and serve pints and then ask you to knock them back. We're now going over to one of the villagers as they're gathered in the local.
Hey, I'm next wench. I'll bring it round here. Where's Alan a Dale?
Oh, he's gone to Nottingham. French are attacking the castle. They've drained all the water out of the ditch round it.
And they'll be here quicker than we thought. They're taking the boat away.
Yeah, well, I'm taking no chances. I'm learning French in case they win. Now, the first lesson is about the family DuPont.
Can you teach us?
Yeah, all right, then. Repeat after me. In the family, dans la famille.
Dans la famille.
Because I'm a fool. This is just what we need to beat the French.
What do you mean?
A little Norman wisdom.
Go on, Norman. Give us a song.
Aye, a song.
Don't love it.
No, no, no.
I saw Farmer Giles, he was getting his hay in. I told him that three of his hens had stopped laying. He says, how do you know that? I says, cause I'm smart. I just run them over with my horse and cart.
I tell you, on the way here today, I did now get a punch on the nose.
What for?
Eating a ploughman's lunch.
What's wrong with that?
The ploughman wanted to eat it himself.
My pal and I met a rich widow last year. We stayed for the night at her cottage near here. He slept with her, then told me I was to blame, cause he felt a bit guilty, he'd give her my name. He hoped that he'd cause me no trouble or strife, cause I was a bachelor and he'd got a wife. He was laughing his head off. What makes it more funny? She's just passed away and left me all her money. I gave a lift in my cart to a witch on the stray who could make me turn into whatever she say. I doubted her word, so a spell she revealed. She put my hand on her knee, I turned into a fiend.
Norman, great. That's what, is that the clue?
That's it.
That's the clue, and I've got to be fair, it's marvellous to have you on the show. Thanks for coming.
Oh, it's a pleasure.
And congratulations on that one-night tour you're doing, and you did the weeks at the Drury Lane, of course.
Yes. Oh, it was very exciting.
One-man shows.
Very, very exciting. I've never enjoyed myself so much. It was absolutely.
Are you doing more of those?
Fancy all those. Well, Drury Lane just makes you go...
Yeah, you've got to be the legitimate actor there, right?
Yes. I've got something special coming up, but it's...
Under wraps?
Secret, mate, yeah.
All right, it's lovely
well,
to do
know one of those things, if you start talking about them...
It never comes
through.
Off. That's right. That's right. Well, Norman, bless you again. That's the clue for Julie and David, and you've got a rhyme for them as well?
There it is.
What does it say?
Take a tip from Alan the Dale. Remember his name, you just can't fail.
Huh? There we are.
Alan
the Dale. Take a tip, you just can't fail. That's what Norman says. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. The great Norman Wisdom. Thank you, Norman. Bless you. Well,
That means I can read you again the bowl of fruit from Anna Dawson, or the gauntlet which came from the Mike Newman sketch. Yeah. Yes, the joust, the tournament. What would you like to hear?
I think the gauntlet, don't you?
Okay.
Okay.
You
went along with it. All right. You went along with that one this time. The nights are getting shorter. The leaves begin to fall. You won't have far to travel if you park against the wall. So.
Could be the bin again.
Yeah, you see, the leaves fall in autumn.
You put them in the
bin. And you put them in the bin. If you burn them, you've got a long way to walk to the bottom of the garden, haven't you?
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
It stands to reason.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Desire.
Of course.
Do you think it's the bin? I mean, can we have a vote? Who thinks it's the bin?
Well, you've got to reject one. Which one are you going to reject this time?
Yeah, come on.
Yeah, get rid of the glove. The gauntlet.
Yes?
Yeah.
Okay, Julie?
Yes.
All right, you're getting rid of the gauntlet, which came from Mike Newman. That's the rhyme I've just read you, and let's see what it says. Rejecting the gauntlet. Well, when leaves begin to fall, where would you put them? On a bonfire? Or is there something passed against the wall? Yes, you have rejected the shortest night on our show, Sir Dusty Bin. You've done it. Well, at least come and meet him. Nobody gets a chance to say it. He gets rejected so many times. My goodness, never mind. You've done it. You've got rid of it. You're going to take something decent home tonight. Well, our last sketch features Robin Hood, a man known for his good deeds around Nottingham in 1334 BC, before Clough. We're now going to join him and his merry men in Sherwood Forest.
Four. Listen, Robin, you better get the kettle on. Maid Marian will be here in a minute.
Oh, you know, I'm getting fed up with that woman. Get the kettle on, roast the chestnuts, nag, nag, nag. Wipe your feet before you climb that tree. I've only just cleaned it.
She does keep the forest nice and clean.
Who wants a clean forest? We can't even have a war council in the Fairy Glade today. She's got people coming for tea. I don't know why she brings them here. This is supposed to be a secret hideout.
She has done quite a lot for us, though.
She's ruined us. Ever since she had that crazy idea about robbing the rich, the gift of the poor, it's been nothing but trouble.
Well, listen, we're not going to start robbing the poor again, are we?
Well, why not? They might not have so much money, but they're a damn sight easier to rob. Where's little John?
Here I am, Robin.
Little John, look at the size of him. If the enemy ever caught you, they'd use you as a battering ram. And you're just the opposite.
I know, I'm a bit overweight, Robin.
A bit overweight? The last time I carried you over a stream, I had to make three trips. It beats me what you keep under that cassock.
It's my tuck box.
And you, what about you? Why can't you wear green like the rest of us?
I'm Will Scarlet, ain't I?
That's not scarlet, it's shocking pink.
I got caught in a storm with a colour rag.
Well, I've had it. I really have, mate. I was better off in a castle with a proper cook and a roaring fire.
But what about waking in the morning to the merry birds singing?
Oh, yes, that's another thing. Ever since she's French polished all the trees, they can't get a grip on the branches. Shouting their heads off all night long, they are.
Robin! Have you done the washing up and got the deer on the spit?
Oh, I'd like to put her on a spit one of these days. What's happened now?
Listen, it's Maid Marian. She's fallen in the bear pit.
Oh, what's all the screaming about?
It's the bear trying to get out.
It's Robin Hancock.
It is indeed, mate.
Now,
yes.
Wait, what claim have you got to be Robin Hood?
A bloke of my caliber. I was born in Bow and educated in Arrow.
I'll take that. Okay.
There you are.
So that's it, Chris. You're leaving the bow and arrow as
I am
the clue.
Indeed. Yes, Ted.
What's
and
the
this
rhyme?
Is the rhyme. Take aim and fire. Don't give it a miss. Chin up and chest out. There's something in this.
There you are. Chris Emmett, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Chris. Thank you. Good going. Okay. Now, I can read the lute that Norman Wisdom left, or again the bowl of fruit that Anna Dawson left. What one would you like to hear again? I can't read that
again. You can't read that one again.
No, not yet, no. I can only read one of these two here.
What do you think? No, no, let's have that one again.
Okay, then.
You want to hear the lute from Norman Wisdom?
Yes, yes.
Norman said, take a tip from Alan a Dale. Remember his name, you just can't fail.
Yeah. I think that's a car. Alan a Dale, AA, Automobile Association. You can't fail.
Oh, yeah.
Wishful thinking.
It's a bit bright, isn't it?
Yes,
well, what are you reckon? You have to reject
I think,
one.
I think that's booze, and I'm
You've said that all along, haven't you?
I'm going teetotal, Ted.
Really?
Yeah, we'll reject that.
All right, how about that, Julie?
Okay, yes.
You want him to get off the booze?
I don't think
it's possible. Okay, I'll read you this one again. It says, step on the juice, don't ask for more. If you take half of this, you're one over the four. And you're rejecting it. And if you step on the juice, of course, you would get wine. And it would have been one over the four. If you drank all of it, you'd definitely been one over the eight. Because you have done what you thought all along. You've rejected a year's supply of wine with these four silver goblets and drink out of it that you... This the whole prize is worth £1,850.
Oh, no.
Look at this. A whole year's supply of wine, those fabulous goblets, nearly £2,000 worth, huh?
Yeah.
But you were right, you worked it out. Yeah. Okay, Jenny, it's been rejected, it has to go. Folks, back to the table. Right, there goes the bowl of fruit. We're now down to two. Uh-huh. Okay, there's a strawberry there. No, it's not a prop, it's a real one. I'll eat that later. Now, I can read both of these, of course, again. Take aim and fire, said Chris. Take aim and fire, don't give it a miss. Chin up and chest out, there's something in this.
Take aim and fire. Photographic, do you think, yeah?
Chin up.
Like
oh, yes.
Chin up.
That's
but
a good
what about
rule.
Chin up, you know?
Well, you've got to look up in the photograph.
Chest out.
Well, let's...
No, chest out and off the booze.
Hold on.
Oh, God, sorry.
Yeah, this one said, take a tip from Alan a Dale. Remember his name. You just can't fail.
Oh, dear, that's
so it's a choice you've got to make. You have to reject one. Which one will it be?
I think that's photographic equipment.
Okay, let's
And I think that's a car.
Let's reject the...
Reject the bow and arrow.
Reject
really?
The bow and arrow.
Yeah, go
on. Unanimous about that?
Quickly, before we change our minds.
Okay, you're rejecting the bow and arrow from Robin Hood from Chris Emmett. Believe it or not, you would have won this bow and arrow. And, of course, a bow and arrow, without a bow and arrow, well, you've got to have a target, right?
Yeah.
So let's bring on a target. We've got a target for you right here. We would have given you an arrow. Well, of course, with a bow, at a fairground, you'd have to fire at a target. We'd have given you an arrow to a point into three of these prizes. Just come up and have a look. There's a TV set there, there's goblets, an antique clock, there's two digital watches, a camera, you were right there, and some porcelain there. And this prize, of course, would have been worth £1,000.
Yeah.
It's gone, you've rejected it.
Yeah,
okay. What have we won? Doesn't take much to work that out, does it? Norman Wisdom's loot. You've got to have this, you've got to take it home with you.
Yeah,
but don't forget, we don't have a car every week.
That's true,
Well, we told you, you couldn't fail if you remembered his name, which, of course, is Wisdom. Yes, you should have taken a tip from our star, and you have, of course, because you've kept it to the last, and you've won tonight's star prize, the car. Done it on our very first show, ladies and gentlemen. That's it. You can't wait to get home. Great prizes on our show each week. Do tune in and see us next week. Once again, we'll have a lot more for you in 3, 2, 1. Have a good week, everybody. Bye now.